Hi everyone, my name is Daniel Walter Scott and welcome to the next design challenge. In this challenge, we are going to be redesigning our website. So this is going to be a UX or user experience design challenge. So what are these design challenges? They are fun, simple, short projects to help you practice your skills, hopefully push you to learn some new ones and help you become a better designer. So who is this design challenge for? It's open to everybody, but really I've aimed it at people who are new to both the design industry and the related design software. So there is no need to have any kind of previous experience, in this case, web design or user experience design. Okay, you just need a willingness to give it a go. The brief, what are you meant to do? In this particular challenge, you are going to be redesigning the BYOL challenges.com website, link there. I've kept the current design really simple to give you a bit of creative license for this particular project. Let's quickly jump into the screen now and I'll give you a little tour.
So this is the site you'll be redesigning. You're looking at an old previous challenge, and you can use this one to take the details like the headings and the text, the images to use in your own new design. So we're redesigning the look of this page. Here's the URL. I'll add it to the downloadable brief in the download files as well.
It's got things like the challenge name, the deadline, description, the video. There's a few icons and thumbnails that you need to incorporate. And down here, kind of a big part of it is the submissions for students. Okay, we've got this kind of like tile grid system going on at the moment. Couple of side notes. One is congratulations for everyone that submitted their entry to the previous challenge, which was the logo design. Okay, just some amazing work. And like, I can't believe how many people are getting behind this and how handsome some of the logos are. The other side note is that you do not have to have done the previous challenge to do this current one. I'll make them all stand alone. But if you did do the last challenge, this would be a really good time to use your own logo up here. Okay. And use that logo that you made to help influence the design of the site. If you haven't created a logo, or if you just want to play with somebody else's logo, you can pick through some of the supplied logos in the download files. So in the exercise files under logos, there is a selection of logos that you can use. I've talked to the designers and they are okay to share their designs with you to use in your project. It's very gracious of everybody. So there's a few to pick from in there. Okay, if you want to, if you don't have a logo to start with, or if you just want to explore somebody else's logo, it's got to make sure you credit them. There'll be a Word doc in here that explains who made the different logos and just kind of give them a high five and explain that's where you got the logo from. In terms of your redesign approach, you can kind of do it two ways. You can simply just play with things like fonts and colors and icons and images, okay, but basically leave everything where it is. Or you might go through and do a little bit more of a UX project where you actually start considering who this is for and start adjusting things like placement and language, moving things around, adding things, taking things away, okay, based on who this site is for. Now to help with that, I've created a persona. Okay, so it'd be very common in a UX project to create your user profile or persona, okay, just explaining who this website is intended for. So I've created this for you. So have a read of this, get an idea of who Jasmine is and what she needs out of this website so you can make some decisions, not based on what you think looks nice, but what would work for Jasmine in her particular path. So either come back here and pause it and watch it, or in your exercise files, there'll be one in there called Persona User Profile. So have a read of that and let that help drive some of the design choices you make for the website redesign. Now the words UI, UX, user experience design, web design, those words might scare some people, but that's a good thing. You can turn scared into exciting new thing to learn. You can check out one of my courses for a bigger picture, but the small picture of a UX project looks like this. First step is to clarify who the website is for. And in our case, it's for Jasmine. So have a read through her persona so you get an idea of who you're designing a website for. Then you shift to a really simple wireframe. Put in everything that needs to go on the website in really simple, basic wireframe format. This is a completely different other project, more just as an example of how simple a wireframe can be. From there, you go get inspired by other people's work and you create something called a mood board. Basically just lots of screenshots of websites that you like the look of and think that will fit the Jasmine's user profile. And I've just done screenshots here and just dumped them all on a page. And then from there, you did the pretty version or the high fidelity version. You can see my version, obviously not for this particular project, just another project. Okay, the one we actually cover in my Adobe XD course, and you can turn it into a nice looking version. So you start with your user profile, draw up a real basic wireframe, get some inspiration, and then design the look and feel of the final version. Now there's more to UX, but for this challenge, that's the nuts and bolts of it. And if any of the terms are really foreign to you, or you just need a recap of the topics, I'll put a link to the relevant videos in my course. That'll get you up to speed. And if you're not a subscriber to my courses, you can just try YouTube. There is plenty of UX resources out there at the moment. So what software should you use? You can use some of the specific user experience design software, things like Adobe XD, Figma, Sketch, Vision Studio are the big ones, but you can use anything. You could use Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, like Jack Caffrey in the last challenge. Do not let software get in the way of your creativity. So if you did decide that this is a really good excuse to learn a little bit more about user experience design, check out my course. It's called User Experience Design Essentials, where we learn Adobe XD. So there'll be a link in the description for that. Submitting your work. Do it at BYOLchallenges.com. Okay, and there's a button there to submit your work. Looking for a JPEG. Okay, so just take a screenshot or export a JPEG of your high fidelity or your good looking version. If you did get a chance to do the wireframe and the mood board, okay, upload those as well. It'd be great to see your progression. Once you've uploaded yours, go and check out at least two others. Okay, and offer some feedback. It might just be positive reinforcement, or you might have some questions or offer some advice, because that's what this kind of challenge idea is all about. It's about learning, getting a bit better, sharing feedback, a little bit of group community. As well as sharing on the site, share on social media, check out any of these. Okay, choose your poison and make sure you tag me. And also we'll use the hashtag BYOLChallenge. Okay, next bit. The next thing is the deadline. The deadline is in the top left of the challenge website. When it's finished, we'll have an after party for the challenge where it's a live event. There'll be a link in the description right now where you can set a reminder. That after party is just where we all get together and I talk about some of the more interesting submissions. So I hope you're ready to practice your UX design skills. If this area is new to you, I hope this challenge is your first leap into the topic. Just remember though, these challenges are not about winning. It's not about being the best. It's about being just a little bit better designer than when you got started. So learn some new skills, practice existing skills, and I will see you all at the live stream after party. Secret. Can you tell that my six-year-old cut my hair this morning? How's it look from the front at least? I think you did a pretty good job. Lockdown lifestyle, right?